Let us have an understanding on Spark session. So we were discussing on the Spark context, the object which is going to coordinate the entire application management across the cluster. Over a period of time, what happened? There are other applications or other processing methodologies within the Spark got developed, like stream processing, SQL processing, and integrating with Hive. For every such tools or components, a separate context happened to get created. So from Spark 2, they introduced a Spark session where it's going to be a superset for Spark context, SQL context, and all the context that we are going to have within the Spark. So we don't need to create the individual context according to the processing that we are going to do. We can observe this if we log into a Spark shell. We can see the Spark context and Spark session will be provided. We can use either one of them, and it is always recommended to use Spark session from version 2 onwards. Let me open up a Spark Scala shell. Spark shell is a separate application and that's going to provide the Spark context. Along with the Spark context, it provides the Spark session as well as a variable called Spark. And it runs locally. This is the application ID and it exposes its web UI in port 4040. Well, I can do a sample code within Spark session. I'm going to invoke the read class, a file called readme. Since I started in the local mode, the location where I started, it will try to read this specific file, readme.md. It's giving a value 103. That means I have 103 lines within this specific file. So this shows I'm able to run the Spark Scala shell. Similarly, I can open the Python shell as well. Here also we have the Spark session as a variable Spark. Let me read the same text file. I'm getting the answer 103. That means Python shell is also working. By default, all Linux systems comes with Python, so we don't need to install Python. If it is Windows, we need to install Python as well, PySpark shell to work. To come out of the shell, say quit. And similarly, it provides a Spark SQL shell as well. It takes the instructions very similar to the SQL query. I'm checking what are databases available. I have the database that I just now created. Let me use this database. For all the query that I'm going to provide now, this specific database will get used. I'm going to create a table using a JSON file available as a part of the example location. Create table employees. I'll be having two columns, name as a string and salary as long. Using a JSON file within this specific location. Examples, src main resources employees.json. Within the installation location, this specific file does exist. I can check whether the table got created or not. Yes, I am able to retrieve some data. So this is a proof we are able to make the Spark SQL as well the Python PySpark and Scala shell we are able to invoke. And all this shell gives access to the Spark session as well.